seem like the Roman legionnaires riding to the rescue, but they're not. They're outraged husbands, every one of them. The Sabine husbands whose wives were carried off by these backwood beatniks from ancient Rome. Very ancient Rome. It's this grubby-looking bunch of recruits who are the Roman legionnaires.
You've undoubtedly accepted the fact by now that Rome wasn't built in a day. The first man who said it was probably Romulus himself, the founder of Rome. And he probably coined the phrase when his brawny and headstrong young followers asked him insistently, "Where are the women?"
Yes, and where were the women? Those strange creatures, delicate, captivating, and indispensable, were not included among the first settlers of Rome. So the young Romans tried to repair matters for themselves, first by begging, then by borrowing, and finally by... No, you couldn't exactly call it stealing. You see, while some young ladies resented it, there were others who delighted in the rape of the Sabines.
We doubt if this film will fill a gap in your knowledge of ancient history. But there's no doubt at all that it will broaden your mind. The Rape of the Sabines.
The Rape of the Sabines. One of the bawdiest stories in history. Made acceptable for the entire family by a delightful cast.
Mylène de Monjeau as the Vestal Virgin beloved by Romulus, played with humor and verve by the handsome Roger Moore. Rosanna Schiaffino and Jean Marais sparkle in the roles of the gods, Venus and Mars. Folco Lulli as the good King Titus. Giorgio Moll as the winning Lavinia. Sheila Gabel as the stormy Duzia. Luisa Mattioli as one of the more willing of the Sabine girls. Claude Conti as the leader of the outraged husbands. And with Walter Barnes, Francis Blanche and Marino Mazet.
La Dolce Vita as it was lived in Rome nearly 3,000 years ago. The Rape of the Sabines. A tender,
warm,
very warm. Hilarious comedy. The Rape of the Sabines. Don't miss it. Coming to this theater soon.